Hello international students, welcome to ESC Clermont Business School. This is Mohammed from the International Relations Office. We are all super excited to welcome you in ESC Clermont within a couple of days. So we are going to show you how our campus looks like. We are going to show you the facilities of the campus. Follow me for the visit. Before we start the visit, we remind you that, of course, we have taken a lot of measures to welcome you in the best possible way. There are masks that are available, gels, social distancing rules that are there in order to make sure that, that you are welcome in the best possible and safest way that is there. So you will see that we have two parallel buildings of ESC Clermont Business School. The first building that we are in is the Truden building, and the building that's right next to it is the Banzac, two different buildings that are attached to each other. So we will continue with the visit. Once you enter into the school, you have the reception on your right, where you can always ask my colleagues for help. Also, you will see that there is a screen which shows which classroom you have, what is the professor, room number, and what is the time of the class. Also, a few steps later, you will find the map of the school, which has the full list of rooms that are there, departments, and so on and so forth. So now we are going to continue with the visit, and the next stop is going to be the Info Lab, which is the platform, the space, where you will be able to access digital resources and to study over there if you wish. So over there you will see that there is the Info Lab, the digital resources, and on the other side there are the student association, that is what we call the BDE. The BDE is the student union, which is responsible for managing the different associations of the school. And also there are offices of a few other associations over there as well. So yeah, over here you have, like we said, the student union, which is responsible for managing the student life. And right in front of it, you have the information center. So here is the information center where you're able to study or to access your digital resources. There are computers that are there. There are places for you to study as well. So as you can see, it's a very quiet place because usually students, they can come with their laptops and then work on projects or do individual study over here. And there is also the graph lab, which is a sort of an area where we shoot some professional videos with the help of the students as well. So we continue to the upper stairs, upper floor. So over here, as you can see, there is the library area where you are able to borrow some books, some materials that you're using for your assignments or for your study experience. The access to the books, you're always able to borrow the books from the top floor of the information center. And if you need any help regarding one certain book in particular, there'll always be someone over there to help you out. So now we are going to go to continue with the visit. There's an exit over there. So here, we continue with the visit. You will notice the world map, which represents the partnerships that ESC has with the different universities around the world. We have more than 100 partner agreements with the universities worldwide. You'll notice in Europe, Africa, all over the place, in every single continent, we have partnerships. Over there on the right, you will see the communication department, which is responsible for the promotion of the school. So producing of any promotional material, and they're also responsible for student recruitment in France itself. So we continue with the visit. Over here, there is a seating area where you can just chill, relax, and there is a coffee machine where you can order your coffee, hot drinks, and also there are the toilets over there. On every single floor, there'll be of course toilets, and there are also different other vendor machines and coffee machines that are located on every single floor that you're able to use. Also, as we are very ecological, you have different waste boxes that are differentiated, so between plastic, paper, and non-recycled. So here is the coffee machine where you can get your coffee. To start off the day well, and then you can enjoy it over there. You can just grab your laptop. There are also chargers or your phone or whatsoever. And over there, on our right, we have the auditorium, which is an event venue. It's a big conference room. So now we are going to move to the second part of the visit, where we get to explore so the different offices, departments that are there, classrooms, and so on and so forth. So now let's discover the second part of the visit, where we get to see the different departments and the different classrooms. And over there you can always see also where you are going to guide you out to avoid you getting lost while you are in the school. So yeah, for now we are going to discover what's there on the ground floor in terms of offices and in terms of departments that are there. So on the ground floor, in this part, there are the offices that are related to the programs. So the bachelor program, the master in management, and the MSc. The heads of programs, as well as their assistants, they are located in this floor. And if you have any doubts that are related to the courses themselves, those are the people that you need to refer to. Here you have also a room for professors, because we welcome, as you can imagine, professors that are coming just for a few courses that are not permanent employees of the school. So in this case, they can use this room in order to prepare their courses and just to sit over there. There are also some photos to show the history of the school. It's a very old school that was established in 1919. So last year it was a huge celebration, the 100th anniversary of the school. So those are some photos to show the history of the school. So yeah, like we said, over here we have so the master in management. And then if we continue further, we have the offices that are related to the other programs as well. You see here there are some photos that are way older than other photos. And yeah, so over there, if we continue towards the end of the corridor, there are the offices, so for the bachelor program and for the MSc programs. So now we are going to go upstairs to see what's there on the other different floors. So now we are on the first floor of the building. You will notice that in this part, so the Banzac, the one we talked about before in the beginning of the video, the majority of the offices that are located are administrative offices, whereas the second part of the building, so when we go back to Trudem, it will be the classrooms, they will be located over there. So let's see what are the services that are there on the departments. So you will notice that on your right, there is the accounting department, where you will be in contact with my colleagues regarding the payment of your tuition fees. And then you have also different offices of various professors of the school that are spread over this corridor. So this is the accounting service. Also, when you want to use the printer, you'll have the chance to do it through your student card that you will receive later by the beginning of the academic year. So we continue towards the end of the corridor. The majority of your, what we call your academic advisors, for every student that is coming from a partner institution, you will have an academic advisor, someone who's responsible for your academic stay in the school. Three of those advisors are located over there at the end of this corridor, and one other advisor is located on the other side of the building that we will show later on. So now let's see the offices of the advisors, academic advisors that are located over here. So there is Kevin, who's responsible for mainly the US and a few other countries. There is Marie Vigier, and there is Pilar Aguilier. So this is the first office that is of Kevin. And some of you would have been already in contact with those academic advisors. And then there is Marie and Pilar over there. And you always have the room numbers in all cases. So now we continue with the visit. We are going now to the second part of the building. So back to Trudem, where we see the classrooms over there. Notice also that there are, of course, toilets on the first floor as well. You have a water machine where you can get cold or hot water as well. And then here, there are also the offices of various colleagues, professors of the school. Over there on the right, there is the quality and accreditations department, the ones that are responsible for the different accreditations that the school holds, so AAPAS, AMBA, as well as AACSB. And then you will notice that you always have signs to show you where you are going, like we said, to avoid you getting lost in the school. And then you have here some rooms that are a bit less visible than others. So here you have 245 and 246. So do have this mentality of always checking wherever you're going. And now, so there is the student administrative office, which is responsible so for the registration process, student cards, and many of the administrative formalities that you will be obliged to follow. So here it's office number 213, and my colleagues, they have made a small box where you can leave your documents. So you will, of course, receive all the instructions by email. It's really to respect the social distancing in case they're not able to give an appointment. Otherwise, then, of course, we are happy to welcome you based on an appointment system. And now we are moving back to Trudem, so to the other part of the building. Over here, you will notice that there is also an area where you can sit. You can use your laptop phone, and you have also chargers and chairs over there. Sofas also, just to sit and relax if you wish. Now, all the rooms that start with the digit 2, they are going to be located on the second floor. And the third floor, it has the same structure. So all the rooms that start with the digit 3 are located rather on the third floor. So you have rooms that are way bigger than others, what we call amphi. It's like a big classroom that can welcome more than 30 or 40 students. And then there are other classrooms that are a bit more small for smaller groups, because sometimes you'll be mixed with so many students, and other times you'll be split into small groups. That's, of course, being currently reviewed to respect even more so the social distancing. So now let's go to the second floor in order to see where is the location of the International Relations Office, where our offices are located. So here we are on the last floor, and you will notice, like we said, that the rooms that are located over here, the classroom, they start with the digit number 3. And this is where also the International Relations Office is located. So, in the beginning there is my office and Lisa's. So me and Lisa, you've been already in touch with us before your arrival. And then you have Audrey's office, who's the head of the service. And then the last office is for the colleagues that are responsible for outgoing students. So for students who are sent to the different partner universities. And then you have a few classrooms over here also in the third floor. Now we are going to move to the cafeteria and the area where you can have so your lunch. So here is the cafeteria. So here you can bring, of course, your own lunch. And then you have microwaves over there where you can heat your meal. Or, of course, by the start of the academic year, this restaurant is going to be open and functional once again, where you have different menus nearly every single day. You have vendor machines over there as well. You can fill water, hot water, cold water. And then, yeah, you can just sit over here. If you want to work, sometimes it can be a bit noisy, especially during the lunch break. But yeah, some students, they prefer to sit over here. And then we have also some fun rooms that are more cozy, that are more relaxed, where there is billiards, which is available. There is baby food. And yeah, this place is just basically to chill and relax. So as you can see, it's very nice, very cozy. We have also a ping pong table over there. And yeah, some students, they prefer to just sit, relax, discuss together, and make friendships and contacts as well. Okay, so on the same level as the cafeteria, you have also different classrooms that are very hard sometimes for students to find out, so we would like to give you the occasion to see those rooms so that you know that, okay, the rooms that are from 1 to 10, they are located over there. So here are those small classrooms, like we said, so between 1 and 10, they are located over here. Remember, on the same level as the cafeteria area. So that's it for the school tour. As we said before, we are very much looking forward to welcoming you in the best conditions that are possible. We hope you enjoyed the tour, and we really hope you a safe trip, and we are eagerly awaiting your arrival in France in order to be able to welcome you.